Why evolution makes everything evolve into crabs. Have you ever noticed how evolution seems to have an uncanny obsession with turning creatures into crabs? Welcome to the fascinating world of carcinization, nature's peculiar tendency to repeatedly transform various crustaceans into crab-like forms. It's one of evolution's most curious patterns. Completely different animal lineages independently developing the same body shape over and over again. But why crabs specifically? What's so special about this particular design that nature keeps returning to it like a favorite blueprint? This captivating phenomenon was first identified in 1916 by English zoologist Lancelot Alexander Borradaile, who poetically described it as the many attempts of nature to evolve a crab. He wasn't just being fanciful, he had recognized a genuine pattern in evolutionary history that continues to intrigue scientists today. The evidence is compelling. Researchers have documented at least 5 independent evolutionary paths leading to the classic crab shape, that flat, wide body with a tucked under tail and a distinctive sideways scuttle. Think about that for a moment. 5 separate times, entirely different creatures faced the pressures of natural selection and arrived at essentially the same solution. Isn't that remarkable? Look at the king crabs. Those massive seafood delicacies weren't always shaped like typical crabs. They evolved from hermit crab ancestors that once relied on snail shells for protection. Over millions of years, they developed their own hardened abdomens and broader bodies, effectively becoming true crabs through an entirely separate evolutionary pathway. Porcelain crabs tell a similar story, having evolved from squat lobster relatives. Then there's the impressive coconut crab, the largest land-dwelling arthropod on Earth, which also began its evolutionary journey from a very different form before adopting its current crab-like appearance. Even more fascinating, sometimes evolution runs in reverse. A phenomenon dubbed decarcinization, where true crabs evolve away from the classic crab shape. It's happened at least 7 times. This evolutionary back and forth raises so many questions about the forces driving these changes. And of course, the internet has embraced this concept with gleeful abandon. Everything eventually evolves into crabs has become a popular meme, with jokes about humans someday evolving crab claws and sideways walking. While scientifically exaggerated, these memes capture something intuitively compelling about carcinization, this strange recurrence that suggests certain body plans might represent optimal solutions in evolution's grand experiment. What invisible forces keep pushing creatures toward crabification? What advantages does this particular body plan offer? And could other optimal forms be waiting to be discovered in evolution's playbook? The answers lie in a perfect storm of advantages that this body plan offers across multiple survival categories. First, let's talk about mobility. Have you ever watched crabs move? That distinctive sideways scuttle isn't just amusing to watch, it's remarkably efficient. Crabs can dash rapidly across sand, rocks, and seafloor while maintaining a low profile. Their flat, wide bodies allow them to slip into narrow crevices that predators can't access. And unlike their lobster cousins who primarily move forward and backward, crabs can navigate in any direction without turning their bodies. This 360-degree movement capability gives them exceptional maneuverability in complex environments. The defensive benefits are equally impressive. Picture a crab's body. That hardened carapace acts like a shield, protecting vulnerable organs. Meanwhile, their abdomen, the tasty part that lobsters and shrimp leave dangerously exposed, is neatly tucked underneath, hidden from hungry predators. When danger approaches, many crab species can quickly bury themselves in sand or mud, leaving only their periscope-like eyes exposed. How's that for a tactical advantage? But perhaps the most significant benefit is ecological habitability. The crab body plan has successfully conquered almost every aquatic habitat imaginable, from the deepest ocean trenches to mountain streams, from coral reefs to hydrothermal vents spewing toxic chemicals. Some have even transitioned to spending significant time on land, like the remarkable coconut crab that can climb trees to harvest its namesake fruit. What forms of natural selection might be driving so many creatures towards this same body plan? Do you think the crab form represents an evolutionary perfect storm that we might see repeated in other environments or even on other planets? Let us know what you think in the comments below. The crab design also offers specialized feeding opportunities. Those distinctive claws aren't just for defense. They're precision tools that can crack shells, tear flesh, filter feed, or delicately pluck algae. Some mangrove crabs have claws so specialized they can remove the protective shell from a snail without damaging the meat inside, nature's own shellfish utensil. Reproductive strategies benefit from the crab form too. Female crabs can carry and protect thousands of eggs under their folded abdomen, like a built-in nursery. This arrangement allows for both high reproductive output and maternal protection, a parenting win-win that many other marine creatures lack. When we consider all these advantages together, it becomes clearer why evolution keeps rediscovering this body plan. The crab form isn't just another random shape. It represents a kind of evolutionary optimization, a sweet spot where mobility, defense, feeding ability, and reproductive success all reach impressive levels simultaneously. It's nature's way of saying, "This design works so well, I'll use it again and again and again." Peeling back the hard exterior of carcinization reveals a fascinating world of genetic mechanisms and evolutionary biology at work. What's happening beneath the shell that drives this remarkable convergence? The answer involves an intricate dance of genes that choreographs development in surprisingly similar ways across different lineage branches. At the genetic level, researchers have discovered that carcinization involves complex changes in homeotic genes, the master regulators that control body patterning during development. In particular, studies of anomura and brachyura, two major crab-containing groups, reveal distinct patterns of gene expression that direct the flattening of bodies and tucking of abdomens. It's like different composers independently writing remarkably similar symphonies without ever hearing each other's work. The developmental pathways leading to crab-like forms involve sophisticated regulation of genes controlling exoskeleton formation, limb development, and body segmentation. What's particularly intriguing is how these pathways can produce such similar outcomes, despite starting from different genetic backgrounds. Imagine artists using completely different materials, yet creating nearly identical sculptures. That's essentially what evolution has accomplished with crabs. One of the most exciting recent discoveries in this field came in 2021 with the identification of Crustacea anthonata, a 100-million-year-old crab perfectly preserved in amber. This remarkable fossil revealed that crabs had already conquered land and freshwater environments during the dinosaur era, much earlier than scientists had previously thought. The specimen's incredible preservation shows minute details of its gills and fine hairs, providing unprecedented insights into ancient crab anatomy and ecology. This finding revolutionizes our understanding of carcinization's timeline and suggests the crab form has been a successful evolutionary strategy for much longer than we realized. What other secrets might be locked in the fossil record, waiting to reshape our understanding of this evolutionary pattern? Carcinization offers profound implications for broader evolutionary theory. It represents one of the clearest examples of convergent evolution, the process where organisms not closely related independently evolve similar traits due to similar environmental pressures. This challenges us to reconsider how predictable evolution might be. Is the natural world full of optimal solutions that selection will inevitably discover? Or is evolution primarily shaped by random historical contingencies? The crab example suggests that certain body plans may indeed represent optimization peaks in what biologists call the fitness landscape, theoretical terrains where some shapes simply work better than others. Perhaps evolution isn't as unpredictable as we once thought. If we restarted life on Earth, would crabs emerge again? Many evolutionary biologists now think they might. Future research directions in this field are incredibly exciting. Scientists are using advanced genomic tools to compare the genetic basis of carcinization across different lineages. Others are employing biomechanical modeling to quantify exactly how and why the crab shape provides such advantages. Some researchers are even exploring whether similar convergent patterns might predict the forms of life on other planets. What carcinization ultimately teaches us about evolution is how creative yet practical natural selection can be. Evolution doesn't create perfect organisms. It works with available materials to produce the best possible solutions given existing constraints. The crab form isn't universally optimal, otherwise everything would be a crab, but it represents a remarkably successful compromise for creatures facing certain ecological challenges. The enduring mystery remains: why crabs specifically? What makes this particular form so repeatable compared to countless other possible body plans? Perhaps there's something uniquely different about the crab design that represents a special case in evolution's toolkit. Or maybe we're simply noticing this pattern more because crabs are familiar and distinctive to human observers. The investigation continues, with each discovery bringing new questions alongside new answers. So next time you spot a crab scuttling across the shoreline, take a moment to appreciate the evolutionary masterpiece before you, a design so successful that nature has independently invented it again and again across millions of years. If that's not worth our admiration, what is? If you enjoyed this deep dive into one of evolution's most fascinating patterns, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more explorations of nature's mysteries. What other evolutionary patterns would you like us to explore? Drop your suggestions below, and as always, stay insanely curious.